before. Now to a story of survival. 5 months ago, you may remember this, the Vickery family heard some dreaded news. They would have to put their dog down. Teddy Bear, as they call him, was beaten while trying to protect his home from thieves. Well, tonight, we are happy to report he is beating the odds. News 4's Mandy Gaither is live and local on this story from our Anderson newsroom tonight. Mandy, first, how's he doing?
Well, Teddy Bear's doing great, and to say he's spoiled is an understatement. Good news, considering 5 months ago, his family wasn't sure if Teddy would live or die. Now, he's beginning to get back to normal.
But it's amazing to look at him now and see, oh my gosh, I mean, he's come so far.
He walks with a little bit of a limp.
You can see how his left leg's kind of in, and his right leg goes straight.
But 13-year-old Teddy Bear is a survivor.
I had really thought about having him put to sleep. That was what the first vet had told us. And my husband was adamant, no. If he dies tomorrow from old age, I'll accept that. But I just can't let these two criminals, you know, take his last days from him.
5 months earlier, Lenora Vickery was heartbroken. The family found their Malamute yelping in pain. His pelvis was crushed. The security camera outside their Anderson home showed thieves in the driveway minutes before. It's believed the dog was beaten while trying to protect his house.
Come get a cookie! Come get a cookie!
Now he's beating the odds, thanks to the Vickeries, who have spent about $3,500 healing the furry member of their family.
I believe, short of our home and our cars, he's the most expensive thing we own.
But it's all worth it as day by day, they watch him get better.
We're real thankful to have him, and I think he's pretty thankful to be here too.
While he still gets stiff on rainy days and is cautious around strangers, Teddy Bear has a lot to look forward to.
We want him to live out his days in the lap of luxury. Good boy!
And the Vickeries plan to make sure that happens.
And the Vickeries say the thieves caught on their security cameras still haven't been arrested. Anyone with information is asked to call the Anderson County Sheriff's Office. Mandy Gaither, WYFF News 4, live in the Anderson Newsroom.